In order to solve the given linear equation, our goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation. And many textbooks give guidelines to solve multi-step linear equations, as we see here. The first thing you probably notice about this equation is that it contains decimals. So we have to decide if we want to work with the decimals or manipulate the equation to eliminate the decimals. And quite often, the first step in solving a multi-step linear equation is to eliminate or clear the fractions or decimals. Remember, if we multiply a decimal by 10, we move the decimal point to the right one place. If we multiply by 100, we move the decimal point right two places. Multiply by 1,000, move it to the right three places, and so on. So looking at our equation, notice how we have two decimal places here, one here, and two here. So to eliminate or clear these decimals, we'll have to multiply every term by 100. So let's go ahead and do that. Remember, as long as we multiply every term by the same value, we have an equivalent equation. So when we multiply by 100, we're going to move the decimal point to the right two places. So for this first product, we'll have 24x. So for the second product, we would have 1,640. Remember, here we have to add a zero because this number only contains one decimal place. And this would equal -148. Now we do have some large numbers, but now it looks like a basic two-step equation. So to isolate x on the left side of the equation, we have to undo this addition here and undo this multiplication here. So for the next step, we'll subtract 1,640 on both sides of the equation. Notice that plus 1,640 minus 1,640 would be zero. So we're left with 24x equals this difference here. And let's be a little careful here. Remember, we can write this as an addition problem if we want to. Minus positive 1,640 is the same as adding negative 1,640. So this is equivalent to negative 148 plus negative 1,640. And now we can follow the rules for adding integers. The rule is if you're adding integers with the same sign, we're going to add their absolute values and then keep the original sign. So we can see right away this sum is going to be negative, which is the same as this difference, and then we'll add their absolute values. Both absolute values will be positive, so we'll have 1,640 plus 148. So we have 8, 8, 7 and 1. So this sum, which is the same as this difference, is negative 1,788. And then for the last step, since 24x means 24 times x, we'll divide both sides by 24. So 24 divided by 24 is equal to 1, so here we have x. Now we need to determine this quotient. We can see it's going to be negative. And since the original equation was in decimal form, we're going to go ahead and give the solution as a decimal. So we'll have 1,788 divided by 24. Again, keeping in mind that we already know this quotient has to be negative. Now we have to figure out how many 24s there would be in 178. That would be 7. And 7 times 4 is 28, carry a 2. And 7 times 2 is 14 plus 2 is 16. This difference is 10. 10 is less than 24, so we know the 7 is correct. Bring down the next digit. Now we want to know how many 24s are in 108. Let's try 4. 4 times 4 is 16. Carry a 1. 4 times 2 plus 1 would be 9. This difference is 12. Now because we want a decimal quotient, we'll have to add a decimal point here, move it up into our quotient, and now we can add a zero here and then bring it down. Now we want to know how many 24s are on 120, and that's good news because there are exactly 5 24s in 120. 5 times 4 is 20, carry the 2. 5 times 2 plus 2 is 12. So this quotient is 74.5. which means our solution is negative 74.5. Now I do want to mention, even though the guideline is to clear the decimals, we could have left the equation in its original form and work with the decimals instead. And if you're allowed to use a calculator, There's no real reason to clear the decimals. And I think I'll quickly show that method. In order to isolate x, we could subtract 16.4. This would be 0. We would have 0.24x equals this difference, which we'll do on the calculator. So we have negative 17.88. And then the last step would be to divide by 0.24. So here we'd have 1x, or just x. And then we can go back to the calculator. And we'd have negative 17.88 divided by 0.24. And of course, we get the same solution as we did using the previous method. I hope you found this helpful.